Good morning, and welcome to our time of contemplative prayer. I can't believe it's Wednesday already. Time is moving very quickly for me right now, and sometimes time moves very, very slowly. And so I was thinking about time today, and this, we're coming up to a year of changing the way that we gather and changing the way of community and embracing opportunities for rest, whether that is a forced rest or whether that is a relieved rest. And so today I thought we would talk a little bit about breath. I just got this new book, Sacred Time, Embracing an Intentional Way of Life. I think for many people, this pause in our busyness over the past year has really posed a question that perhaps we were avoiding for a long time, is what does it mean to be intentional in our lives? How do we embrace the gift that each day brings to us? How do we pay attention to the beauty and the brokenness, the joy and the sorrow in this wonderful, amazing, creative world that we have been given? I was drawn to the following statement, and that is what has prompted me to move into a practice that Christine Walters Painter suggests in this book. Christine says, "The more I grow in trust that when I'm invited to release and rest in my life, flowering and fruitfulness will eventually follow." I just thought that was just so beautiful. There's another new book called Wintering that is out, that is talking about winter in our souls, in our lives, not just in this beautiful world of ours when the snow falls and the temperature gets really cold. But this idea of rest, God gave us, right, the Sabbath day to rest for a very particular reason. And I think that she captures it for me for flowering and fruitfulness. And so one of the most fundamental rhythms and sense of time that we have is our heartbeat, but it's also our breathing. And so I wanted to spend some time just meditating, which means to think about, to pay attention to our breath. So those of you who practice yoga may have practiced a breath practice where you pay attention to your breath and you sort of count it, so to speak. And there are four parts to our breath. There is the inhale. There is the holding of the breath. The exhale, and the pause between the exhale and the inhale. And there is a practice that has us counting that breath. You count to three on the inhale, you hold for three counts, you exhale for three counts, and you pause for three counts. So perhaps you can try it with me. We inhale, one, two, three, hold, one, two, three, exhale, one, two, three, and pause, one, two, three. breath has the ability to calm us down or excite us and give us the energy to run around the block. Paying attention to our breath also gives us the ability to control our sense of time. Draws us closer to the one who gave us breath, the one who breathed life into us and gifted us with fruitfulness and flourishing. Christine invites us to embrace a practice of paying attention to our breath, using that sense of timing, that fourfoldness of our breath, the inhale, the holding, the exhale, and the pausing. She invites us to take slow and full breaths. And to think about the following, which I think is very helpful. As we inhale a slow and full breath, let us think of the dawn, of the sun rising, of us awakening to the day. Perhaps we might even think of the coming spring, when the whole world takes, in our part of the world that is, takes a deep breath in a few weeks and blossoms begin. So as you breathe, pay attention to your inhaling. As you inhale, ask yourself this question. How are you being invited to awaken today? As you inhale, the potential of a new day. Now I invite you to pay attention to that fullness of breath between the inhaling of the breath and the exhaling. The fullness of breath is like the midday. It is like the sun overhead that is enlightening everything. It is like the summertime. When the harvest is coming in, the trees are in full leaf, the flowers are blossoming, and we are full of the oxygen, we are full of life. And so I invite you to inhale and then hold that breath for 3 counts. And exhale. Pause, inhale and hold in the fullness of the sun, and exhale and pause. As you inhale and hold, I invite you to ask yourself, how are you being invited into fullness today? The fullness of who you are, the fullness of your life in the here and now, in whatever way it is manifesting. Thank you. I invite you to focus on your exhale. We inhale, spirit of life, awaken to the day. We pause in the fullness. And now as we exhale, we let go. We release whatever is inside us that needs to be taken out into the world. It is like the sunset. These things that we release are sacred, even though sometimes they could be something negative in our lives, or a past experience that you need to let go of in order to move forward. We inhale, we pause, and we exhale. At the end of the day, it is like fall time as we prepare to let go of our leaves, invite them to drop onto the ground, to become compost for something new. As you inhale and hold, and as you exhale, I invite you to ask yourself, what is it that you're being called to release today? We inhale to awaken. We hold in the fullness. We exhale to release. And then we pause between the breaths. The pause is the emptiness. It is us, it is our Sabbath, it is our rest. It is the waiting. Christine uses the metaphor of nighttime, the unknown, the time of the unconscious. It is like winter, where things are resting, but not. Emptiness is not empty. The void of God's creation is not an empty void. It's just waiting for new life to appear. This is the empty tomb before the resurrection. And so I invite you to inhale and hold the fullness. Release your breath and rest in that emptiness before the next breath. Inhale the awakening, the springing forth. Hold the fullness, the bountiful flourishing. Exhale. Release, let go, prepare, and rest in the pause between breaths. And now I invite you, as you pause, in that emptiness and that winter between the exhale and the inhale of your breath, I invite you to ask yourself, how are you being invited to be still today, to rest? This resting, this pause between the exhale and the inhale, is contemplation. It is the place where we rest in the arms of God, and we trust that God is holding us tight and breathing new life into us. An ancient story about a valley of dry bones, that time where nothing is blossoming, that emptiness, and God blew life into those bones, and they flourished, and they danced. Contemplation, emptiness. Nighttime, winter. This is the time of trust that God indeed will enliven us, resurrect us. God's kingdom is near. Flourishing, abundant life is ours as we inhale the Spirit of God in this place. I invite you to take a few minutes to rest in your breathing. And now I invite you to lift up prayers for the life of this world. They may be for you, your loved ones. They may be for your town, the country, the world. I invite you to type your prayers into the comments if you feel so obliged, and we will continue to pray those prayers throughout the week. I would like to lift up prayers for peace and understanding and healing. And also for prayers for those who have lost loved ones, that they may feel the breath of God permeate their lives. The Apostle Paul tells us that the Spirit of God prays for us with sighs too deep for words and in groaning. Through the life-giving breath of God, we are given all that we are all that we need. And so let us breathe deeply, inhaling the good gifts that God provides and exhaling all the things that we need to release. Let us breathe in strength. Let us exhale our exhaustion. Let us breathe in freedom. Let us exhale all that holds us back. Let us breathe in a new sense of direction. Let us exhale the paths we no longer want to use. Let us breathe in hope. Let us exhale self-doubt. Let us breathe in unconditional love. And let us exhale distrust and hate. O Holy Spirit, let us feel the mighty rush of your presence in this place. Blow away our fears and worries and help us to breathe in your gifts of new life. Amen and amen. I hope you found this breath practice helpful. You are welcome to come back to view this again and again. And you're also welcome to ask me for this practice in writing, because I know it was a lot to do in this short of time. And I would be more than happy to send that to you. I'm so grateful for you to pray with me on these Wednesday mornings. And I hope that your week is blessed and full of breath, and that in this time of rest that you hold on, in this time of almost the end of winter, that you hold on, that there will be a flourishing and abundance that will be yours. I hope you have a great week, and I look forward to praying with you next week. Take care.